Hello everyone, welcome back to Blackjack. I'm Blackjack Aviani, and I have already seen the thumbnail. I know it's called Grievard, and it's a ghost dog, because they said that here. It must be some sort of candle. Okay. There we go. But I haven't... You know what I mean? Oh my goodness! Pure ghost, okay. That's it? That's the whole, well, I guess there's something down here, too.
Okay. I'm here on behalf of Naranja Academy's Ghost-type Pokémon Club, on assignment to find Ghost-type Pokémon. I saw a couple here earlier. Let's see if they're still around. Deep breath. I can do this. Ah! Oh, it's just a Mimikyu. Okay, keep it together. Come on, I know I saw something else here earlier. There it is. Oh, that doesn't look like it's just a candle. Oh my goodness, it's so cute. Hello, look at you. You seem friendly. Who took a Pokemon? Oh, wanna play, huh? Am I really this out of shape? Okay, here we go. Wow. Searching for ghost types really sucks the life out of you. Okay, just one more time.
First, we're expected to go catch those things by the dozens. Oh man! Oh, what does that thing remind me of? The big floppy sheepdog face. There's like some sort of Jim Henson creature, right? I'm trying to remember, maybe... Is there a dog in Labyrinth? I don't remember. It's been so many years since I've seen a lot of these movies. Okay, well, I mean, that was cute. I just wish it hadn't been revealed in the thumbnail. Have you ever noticed that Gengar's smile has been... It used to be very Cheshire Cat, and now it's very Sir Crocodile from One Piece. Especially because they show it smiling with its teeth apart now, like, instead of... And it has, like, that half-lidded smirk. So it's very Sir Crocodile. And so Netbug is probably going to be facepalming going, "Why didn't I think of that?" True story, Netbug lent me her copies of One Piece, I asked her, "So, all of the pirate lords are named after animals?" And she's like, "What? Oh my gosh." She never noticed. I guess I can't say them because one, I don't remember them all, and two, I remember at least two of them are big spoilers. Yeah, I'm just needless to say, they are in fact all named after animals. So, yeah. Anyway, Greavard. I keep wanting to say Greaveyard. But, okay, actually, let's check out the official website. No, not Wikipedia. Okay. Oh, wait, no. I could just go back a page because it was right on the front. It was the very first thing. Okay, meet the ghost dog Pokemon whose spooky cry can be heard in the Paldea region. Okay. Oh, we don't actually get the information on this page. Okay, gotta go up to Pokemon. There we go. It's in the middle for some reason. Oh, it must be alphabetical order. A powerful jaws that can shatter bones. A single bite from Greavard can be grievous. Alright. It's 2 feet tall and weighs 77.2 pounds? Really? I would think it would be extremely light. Okay. It's friendly and easily gets lonely, but make sure not to play with it too much. Greavard has such a friendly and affectionate personality that paying it even the slightest bit of attention will make it so overjoyed that it will follow you wherever you go. Of all the Pokemon residing in the Paldea region, it is known to be especially easy to befriend. However, Greavard will slowly and inadvertently absorb the life force of those around it, so it's best not to play with it too much. Also, slowly. That trailer did not show slowly. That trailer showed in under the span of 60 seconds. So, yeah. Okay, well, I think I've said all there is to say about this thing. Category ghost dog type ghost. Maybe Al can help me figure out where I've seen something that looks like this before, because I don't think it was in Labyrinth, but it does remind me of a Jim Henson thing. So, no, not that setup. This setup. Just, where have I seen this thing before? Where have I seen a big sheepdog with an enormous jaw before? Leave your answers in the comments below. Until next time, I'm Blackjack Aviani, and you're not.